Now, something a few people have asked me to do is a video on how to build an engine trolley. So I'm going to try and show you, you know, how to make a fairly easy trolley. It looks reasonable, you know, with just simple tools. So we've got this timber B&Q. It's about 2.3 meters, and it's a great idea to plan out what you're going to do first. Check that nothing's going to clash. This is going to be a steerable trolley, by the way, with a drawbar. These are the two main runners that I've marked out here, and you really need to try and get the biggest bits out of one run. That's what I've done here. I've made it as long as possible, leaving enough room you know, for truing up. You don't want to just mark one line in the middle. I found that you can end up with one shorter than the other like that. But it's a good idea if you've got one. Where is it? Just use a square like that over there, and just a pencil, and mark it all the way round. That will help you if you're cutting just freehand, as it were. Or if you've got a miter saw like that, you can use that as well. If you're doing it on a bandsaw, then you don't need to do that. Morning all. Here are the lengths of timber I cut for the main trolley timbers for the Amanco. I cut these last night. I think, as I said in the video then, they're not a perfect cut there. So, I'm going to get the plane out today, take that back, and then just sand it. I'll do that on each end. Okay, well, there's the two main timbers with the ends cut. This is something I always think looks nice, if you just cut out the ends a bit. Just looks a bit better than leaving them square. Really easy to do. You just mark all the way around, about halfway down this side, halfway, that halfway measurement along there, and then cut it off. And that's what you'll get. Hard to believe it's the middle of October. The next thing you need to do is work out where the engine's going to go, thereby working out what width your crosspiece has got to be. So the first thing I do is mark the centres of the timbers so I can measure accurately between the two ends. Then measure between the bolt holes, and the centres of those are 21 centimetres, both ends. What I do, mark that. This is now set to 21 centimetres apart, like so, and then I'll cut a piece just adding on the extra bit out from the edge. That way I get a piece the right width, bits and pieces cut out now. Those two are the cross pieces, and this one's for the axle at the front, which is why it's been chamfered all the way around. Okay, that's something of what it will look like. This timber will go on just like that. However, this one will be flush with the surface. And then this, the axle, go on top like that. There'll be a central bolt going through and a plate so it can turn. Bit of metal there that can be greased. Then you'll be able to turn the front axle. Something else that has to be worked out is just how much I'm going to sink that front axle bearer in, front crosspiece, whatever you want to call it. So it should sink into that slot there once I've cut it out. But of course the wheels, the front wheels, are a smaller size than the back wheels because they're the steerable ones at the front. So I've got to work out the difference between the axle height, which is 20 millimetres. So what I've done, instead of sinking this in all the way, I'm sinking it in minus about 15 millimetres, so that I've then got 5 millimetres to put some sort of spacer in between the cross piece and the axle. So I just cut that one out and see how it goes. Okay, you'll have to imagine it's upside down now, but the front cross piece is sunk in, obviously not been bolted down, so it'll pull up tight. So next we've got to move on to the back cross piece, which is just a simple butt joint onto the top there. So we've marked it 2 inches from there. That way it doesn't look like the wheels are right on the end. And it'll be screwed and glued there. But it'll have probably just one coach bolt through the middle, and then the axle blocks will go on top, and the coach screws, rather, for those will go all the way through as well. So it should be quite strong. Okay, well that's both cross pieces fitted. This one's got 4 coach screws, so it's a steerable end. That's the one with 2 for the back. I'll just put a hole in this for the big bolt to go through, the pivot. That'll go in there. It is a tight fix, it needs to be. Go through there as well. Obviously we cut to length. There'll be a washer in there. Stop it moving about too much. There we go. And I've tightened it up enough so it's a little bit stiff, but it's, you know, it's tight enough that the wheels are not going to whip round suddenly on their own. But of course, I will put stops on so it can be unloaded safely. Monty, just to give an idea of what it's going to look like, here it is. Haven't put the back axle on yet, but it's just resting on that. But the front one's in. Obviously all the timber will get cleaned up well before being varnished. I think the front wheels look a little small, but maybe once it's all together it will look better. The trolley will look, there's a lot of empty space on it at the moment, so once it's all back together it'll probably look better. I'm quite pleased with that so far. Spent this morning making the drawbar for the trolley, sorry. It's not a trailer. Kyle, I spent this morning making drawbar for the trolley. Just out of an old scrap bit of pine, well seasoned pine, so it's nice and strong. That's the mounting on the front axle. Take one bolt off and slide the pin out, so it's quite easy to remove. Nice and long so that I'm not bending down to use it. Of course with it in about the right position to hold, it only goes round to there, which is more than sufficient. But if you lower it, it'll go all the way. So it works quite nicely. Of course it'll stay there as well. So I'm going to try and get the back wheels on now. This afternoon's project is going to be to machine some washers for these on the lathe. You can get 20mm washers, but I thought I'd make my own. It's both sets of wheels on. And I'm rather pleased with that. Also, just put it on the level here so I could measure whether each end is level. It's only about 2mm out, which isn't bad really, considering I was guessing most of it. So I'm quite pleased with that. Obviously the wheels aren't fixed properly yet, I've got to have split pins through them. Easy to move. It's quite big as well really. It's probably about, well the main timbers are 4 foot long. It's probably about 700 feet long. Not the easiest thing to do with the use of one hand. Right, let's see what that is now. Sorry if the camera's a bit shaky, I'm trying to hold it with one hand, wind with the other. Not easy. Right, get the old gauge in there. Right, check that out carefully. About another millimetre to go. Trolley finished apart from varnishing. I'm very pleased with that. I had doubts about how good it was going to look yesterday. But now that I've got the handle on it and it's finished, I quite like the look of it now. A lot of people have said to me when I've done these wooden sort of pillow blocks, people have said no way they're going to be strong enough. But I mean, I've even done that on a diesel engine, and that was okay. Done this on quite a few engines, and okay, you just have to be a bit careful, but they're generally quite okay. So the next thing to do really with this is to sand it up. Obviously I've got to take it apart. This handle will come off. Front axle, I'll take that off as well, and then I can varnish the main frame, take the wheels off too. So yeah, coming along. But it's quite big. So I think I said earlier the trolley bit itself is 4 foot long. Your sort of maximum steering, so I don't really need a stop because it can't go further than that unless you're holding it right down. But it will go up the ramps quite well. But you see what I mean about it being big, because those ramps are 6 foot long, so it's about 7 feet roughly in total. I think it will look quite good with an engine on that. But as you can see, it's so much easier to unload, if you like. And of course when it rallies, I can turn that round. And that makes it a bit more compact. There you go. So I hope you like that. I'm not going to focus too much on the varnishing. That's pretty simple really. hope that gives some sort of idea of how I built this and hopefully help someone else out. It's not the best, but it works, you know. So yeah, I hope you like that, and thanks for watching.